would a kitchen look like if it didn't have a bin? Is that a possibility?
Food waste is a huge issue. About 30% of all food that is produced is wasted. And it's wasted at every single part of the value chain.
Globally, food waste drives an estimated 8 to 10% of greenhouse gas emissions, from production through to disposal.
If food waste was a country, it would be the third largest emitter of greenhouse gas emissions.
Imagine if food waste was a thing of the past, where the take, make, dispose model shifts to reduce, redesign, eliminate.
What we're trying to do is to catalyse the industry to recognise that it is entirely possible to redesign food products.
To eliminate food waste and allow nature to thrive, the global food system needs a fundamental redesign for a more sustainable future and a growing global population.
We'd love to be operating in a world where there's absolutely no waste at all.
It's a global system that's really ripe for change.
So is food waste an idea that's past its sell-by date? The modern food system, from harvesting and transport to processing, storage, retail, and cooking, consumes nearly 20% of the world's fuels and electricity. Yet up to 40% of food produced is wasted.
There are so many core things that need to change to tackle food waste along the whole value chain. Waste happens everywhere. It happens at the farm, it happens in production, it happens in transportation, it happens in the supermarkets, and it happens in our own homes.
To put that into perspective, 8% is lost pre-harvest in the farm. 19% is wasted in processing at production. 12% of food is wasted during transportation. 7% of global food waste happens in our supermarkets. 54% of waste in our homes. And around half of food waste occurs before it even reaches the consumer. So how can we eliminate food waste entirely?
There's a lot around perception, so how we value food, and that's a cultural shift that needs to happen around us as consumers valuing the food we consume. There's a huge amount of pressures in our supply chain, whether that be water, biodiversity loss, that we need to deal with. It's just making people in retail sector, in customers' home, aware of the importance and the role they have in tackling food waste at home in particular, and how that will benefit climate change.
So from an environmental perspective, when food waste goes into landfill, it creates methane, which can be up to 80 times more potent as a greenhouse gas compared to carbon dioxide. The good news is that solutions exist to make material reductions in food waste across the supply chain, but we need an urgent focus on this issue to have a chance of reducing it.
So we talk about designing out waste rather than designing from waste, because I think so many efforts today are having to deal with the waste that is already there. A circular economy is an economic model that moves us away from the model that we are in today, which is very linear. It is one where no food that is produced is wasted. All our food regenerates our natural ecosystems, and that nutrients, in whatever form we get them, are circulated at their highest value. We can actually have a food system that really builds those natural ecosystems and regenerates them.
What if food products were designed to eliminate waste from the farm while enhancing biodiversity and ensuring a sustainable, nutritious food system?
When you think about harvesting crops from the field, you often get stalks left over, or the bits that we don't eat get left in the field. Now, what if we were going to extract sucrose and cellulose, which are like the basic building blocks of plants, right? So if we took the sugars and the fibers out of all of that, and from that, we made glucose syrup. And so we utilized the nutrients to be able to produce, in the case of glucose syrup, a new ingredient, meaning that we didn't have to plant corn, sugarcane, or sugar beets to create glucose syrup, because we've used it from upcycled what is currently considered waste. So that's really what a circular economy is. When we think about a circular economy for food, you can apply those principles across all parts of the food system.
So how can the circular principle be implemented across the supply chain? Both small and large retailers are showing it's possible.
So I think our position on this is, how do you design out waste at all parts of the system by upcycling as much as possible? We don't often think about food as being designed, but actually when we think about the food products that we buy in our supermarket shelves, our chocolate bars, our cereal boxes, our loaves of bread, decisions have been made around the kinds of ingredients that have been selected and where those ingredients have been sourced from. Every time we think about how to use a different ingredient or some waste that we need to turn into an ingredient requires innovation.
The opportunity is enormous for the sector as a whole to both do the right thing for the bottom line, but also for people and planet. There are proactive, progressive actors in this space who are really pushing the needle when it comes to waste-free cooking.
At the Ellen MacArthur Foundation, we launched a global challenge, really asking the food sector, can you take a framework that we developed called Circular Design for Food, and can you apply that to food and drink products?
Companies of all sizes worldwide have embraced this challenge.
So Rescued Kitchen is actually a New Zealand-based company, and they rescue bread that would otherwise go to waste, and they remill it and they turn it into baking mixes. This is really interesting. So Creative Nature make a pancake mix. But what's really cool about these ones is that instead of being made with wheat, they're actually made with British fava beans. So they're using diverse and lower impact ingredients to give us the same delicious pancakes. I think what's also really exciting about this is that the pancake mix is packaged in a dissolvable seaweed package. So their primary packaging dissolves when you add the liquid. So it also adds other nutrients that come from the seaweed as well.
From the UK to Southeast India, Green Pod Labs is tackling food waste with a clever solution in a region where waste is particularly acute. And storing fresh produce presents significant challenges during transportation.
In developing countries like India and other parts of Africa and Asia, cold storage is negligible.
Grapes that are produced in central India travels to the northeast India, which takes about 7 to 8 days. It has to travel in the ambient condition, and grapes is a highly delicate commodity. So we are trying to solve this problem, ensuring that the stock of the grapes are fresh till it reaches the end consumer.
By harnessing the natural defense systems in fruits and vegetables, they've created sachets that extend shelf life by up to 60%, slowing ripening and reducing spoilage during transport.
Biotechnology is the last frontier which is going to disrupt the food system in agriculture in the world. It's going to change how the food is produced, it's going to change how the fruit is transported, it's going to change how the food is consumed as well.
These small companies are proving what's possible. But are big retailers ready to embrace the circular model into their operations?
So how do we consider food waste in Waitrose? So what's unique about retail space is that we look both upstream and downstream. And we split up very crudely into three areas: our own operations, our customer segment, and our supply chain. We were one of the first retailers to utilise surplus that we'd identified across our fresh produce. But over the last few years, we've been doing what we call whole chain plans, which is essentially walking our supply chain to identify surplus. And then when we do identify surplus, trying to put it to the best use. Our first and foremost exit route is via humans, via charity, and we use Fair Share as our umbrella organisation to facilitate that. But long term, we'd love to be operating in a world where there's absolutely no waste at all. The wonderful Wonky range offers an end market for produce that would otherwise go to waste. It's stuff, as the name suggests, that probably wouldn't have hit our specs that we would have for our conventional tiered products. We obviously have a huge amount of influence in our supply chain and our own operations, but when it comes to customers' homes, we're constantly trying to nudge them in the direction, a positive direction, when it comes to food waste. So we know that if you're selling more loose products, people can buy more of what they want rather than having to buy bulk packets and potentially wasting those that they don't consume. Another really important reason why customers do waste food is the misunderstanding of use by best before dates is a really obvious one. It's an area that is poorly understood by many, so many will waste food at best before, use the best before date as an indicator of that food has gone off, when in actual fact it's perfectly edible way beyond that. There's been a real learning curve for us when removal of best before and packaging of how we control stock in store and making sure that we're not causing undue waste.
Whilst consumer behaviour change is part of the story, we would say that it is absolutely not where we should be expecting change to be led from. No single organisation can solve our food challenges on their own.
Every commercial kitchen is going to waste food. It's a natural byproduct of the production process of preparing food at scale. The hospitality sector has a massive role in driving down food waste, not only in commercial kitchens, but in terms of changing the way that we all think about food.
The sector currently accounts for a staggering 12% of global food waste, a figure expected to rise as more consumers choose dining out over cooking at home.
Chefs don't have time to manually key in or use spreadsheets or even pen and paper to measure food waste in their kitchen. So at Winnow, we solve that problem with artificial intelligence. So we're teaching a machine to see. It's the same type of technology you'd find, for example, in a driverless car. So Winnow works by putting effectively a supercomputer into the kitchen. We're teaching a machine to see the food as it's being thrown away in real time. Our AI will then do all the hard work and record exactly what was thrown away, the weight and the cost. And then we are able to give teams insights that we know can materially reduce food waste in these kitchens while doing the right thing for their business and also the planet. Today, Winnow is saving somewhere in the region of 87,000 tonnes of carbon dioxide equivalent. To put that into context, that's enough energy to power the homes of a small town for an entire year. More needs to be done to quantify and measure food waste from farm all the way to fork. If we are able to then collectively understand where food is being wasted along the value chain and then create systems where we can come together and address that problem collaboratively.
There is a financial challenge in changing our food system. For every pound we spend on food, there's about £2 worth of associated costs in terms of health and the environment, which is currently not priced into our food system. It's going to be a hard nut to crack. I think at the moment, if you personally want to eat in a way that is helpful to nature, it is probably going to cost you more. But I think we also, this is why it's so important that we need to get to scale, and we need large-scale manufacturers to be really designing thriving natural ecosystems into their products, so the consumer doesn't have to foot the bill.
It costs the economy about $1 trillion every year of lost output. Winnow works all over the world with hospitality businesses like Hilton, Marriott, and many others. We're today saving those businesses $70 million every year.
So how can designing out food waste scale around the world? A growing number of global initiatives are adopting circular models to eliminate food waste. From France's anti-waste legislation mandating supermarket donations of unsold food, to Denmark's WeFood stores offering surplus food at discounts, thousands of efforts are driving change across governments, businesses, and communities.
The business case for tackling food waste is really positive. The less you produce, the less you have to deal with, and then the less process and less cost associated with handling that surplus.
The tools for a waste-free future exist. It's about embracing new norms in production, supply, and consumption. Circular food systems can cut emissions, with retailers key to this shift.
So I 100% believe it's possible. I think food redesign is about saying today we bend nature to produce food, but we can redesign it to enable nature to thrive.
There's a critical mass that we've never seen before in the food sector, addressing and acknowledging the issues that we're facing, but also the action that's being taken is quite extraordinary.
Food waste is one of the defining problems of our time. We prefer to look at it as an opportunity. If we can create new technologies, new processes, we can help reduce that, have a massive impact on the climate emergency, but also save money for businesses around the world.